2010 has been quite a year for our gear-driven robot friends. Here's our review of the year's robot news. And we start with Simon, a robot developed by the Georgia Institute of Technology. Simon has been taught to recognize items and drop them into the corresponding bins. Right now, that makes him good for robot-aided recycling, but the university has bigger plans.
We're interested in robots that you could have in your house and that don't have to be pre-programmed with everything that you would want them to do, and you could teach them new things to do around your house.
And just remember, if Simon goes haywire, press the big red emergency shutoff button. Another robot with sights set on the home is Intel's Herb.
What Herb does is that he's completely autonomous. You just have to turn him on, and what he's going to do is recognize objects, register them, build models of the environment, and do useful things right away.
Intel is building algorithms that enable Herb to figure out things around the home. The robot is based on a Core i7 quad-core laptop computer and has a spinning laser that maps 40,000 points a second to build up a 3D model of its surroundings.
You or I might not want to get a robot that takes 10 minutes to go get us a beer, but there are people like paraplegics on a wheelchair whose entire life depends on not dropping the remote. And so a robot like this that can let them live independently for longer is extremely useful.
Intel doesn't want to sell robots, it buys the parts and builds them so it can develop better software algorithms. We've all had meetings we'd rather not attend. If you have $15,000 lying around, next time you can send an AnyBot. The robot functions as a seeing and hearing replacement for yourself. It can roll around the office as you operate it through a web browser from your home. Thanks to a Wi-Fi connection and a video camera, speaker, and mic in the head, you can even have conversations with work colleagues while you're sitting at home on the couch. A few years ago, there was Paro, the seal robot that was meant to mentally stimulate the elderly at nursing homes. This year, Fujitsu came up with a teddy bear bot. The robot can recognize people and objects and even act accordingly. If you smile, it smiles back. If you wave, it waves back. And when all the play is done, it even gets sleepy. In Japan, Panasonic's eVolta robot completed a 500-kilometer, two-month-long journey from Tokyo to the ancient capital of Kyoto. Designed to promote Panasonic's batteries, the robot previously completed a 24-hour endurance race around Le Mans and climbed to the top of the Grand Canyon.
The first one took only 6 hours, and the second one took 24 hours, and this time it's, you know, a couple of months. It's, you know, much, much longer. That means, you know, much, much harder.
Also breaking records, Cornell University claimed a world record by getting this robot to walk non-stop for 23 kilometers. That's about 14.3 miles. The robot managed the feat in 10 hours, 40 minutes and 48 seconds before it literally collapsed. A team of about 60 students worked on the record-breaking effort, including a controller who kept the robot on course and steered it with a model airplane remote. General Motors' Robonaut 2 had a much loftier target in 2010. The robot was to become the first non-human member of a space crew and blast into orbit on shuttle mission STS-133 in November.
R2 is a humanoid-like robot. He's quite big. He looks like an NFL linebacker, but just from the torso up. And he has hands and fingers just like a human. And we're taking him up and we're going to run him through some experiments on orbit to see how well a humanoid-like robot can serve as an aid to the astronauts.
Unfortunately, the shuttle mission has been delayed to 2011, so for now, Robonaut 2 remains grounded. On four wheels, and Mitsubishi Motors turned to robotic technology to give test drives a new twist. In November, the company offered US drivers a chance to take its new Outlander Sport for a test drive online. It rigged a test vehicle with robotic control systems so it can be remotely controlled via the internet. Cameras inside the car sent back live images to drivers. Mitsubishi said the participants were able to enjoy the feeling of being in the driver's seat, even though they were thousands of miles away. But what about that new car smell? And one of the most impressive robots we saw this year was Panasonic's hair washing robot. It wets, washes, massages, and rinses with 16 electronically controlled fingers. The robot is a little smaller than a washing machine and can run automatically from start to finish in about 3 minutes. So is it the ultimate toy for the lazy? Not quite. Panasonic hopes the robot will be useful in hospitals and care facilities, where it can lighten the load of busy workers. And from Bremen University in Germany, a robot soccer team invaded this year's CeBIT IT show. You won't find these guys in the Bundesliga, but they were reigning 2009 Robot World Cup champions. The pace of the game is a little bit slow because the robots aren't great runners, but they are autonomous, deciding their moves without any human control.
Our software is kind of open source, so we have opened it for everyone to access. It can be downloaded on our website.
If you want to get involved, the robots are based on the French Nao platform. Anyone can download the control software and tinker with it. And if you do that, the teams need a hand in one area.
We have no real goalkeeper behavior. So our goalkeeper is just kind of standing around.
And that's the year in robots. In Tokyo, I'm Martin Williams, IDG News Service.